back to our TV show Topics Around the World. My name is Lotta Wolf.
And my name is Joy Lundsmann.
The topic of today is sexual self-determination. At first, Joy want to talk about LGBTQ+ and what it means. Then I want to talk about LGBTQ history in Germany. And after that, Joy want to talk about the situation in India.
What does LGBTQ+ mean? LGBTQ+ is a term which stands for sexual orientation and gender. L stands for lesbian, which means that two women love each other. G stands for gay, which means that two men love each other. B stands for bisexual, that means that you are attracted to two genders. T stands for transgender. Transgender people are born in the wrong body. They identify as male and are born in a female body or reversed. And Q means queer or questioning. That means you don't label your sexuality. You're just not heterosexual or cisgender.
In Germany, since 1999, the basic law says that people have a right to sexual self-determination, but it has been a long way to achieve this. In the year 1871, paragraph 175 was created, which said that homosexuality is a crime. A few years later, in 1897, there were the first movements in German history that fought for gay rights. In the 20s, there were many clubs and bars for gays. And in 1929, a Reichstagskomitee wanted to vote to abolish paragraph 175, but the Nazis prevented abolition with their assumption of power. During the Second World War, gay people were sent to the concentration camps, and after the dissolution of the camps, those who survived had to serve their sentence under paragraph 175. In the early 50s, East Germany loosened regulation on paragraph 175, and in 1968, paragraph 175, East Germany discrimination homosexual acts over the age of 18. 1 year later, West Germany also eased the regulation on paragraph 175. In 2017, it was decided that same-sex marriage will be allowed and that homosexual couples will have full adoption rights. In 2019, conversation therapy was finally completely banned. But still today, there are some discriminatory rules in society. For example, in Germany, men who had sex with another man in the last 12 months are not allowed to donate blood because they are supposed to have a higher risk of being HIV positive. Unfortunately, there are still some people which do not support LGBTQ+ in Germany.
Sexual self-determination in India. The Supreme Court in India has declared in 2020 that it will take more discrimination against transgender people. Moreover, it recognized that gender identity is based on self-determination. Transgender people are often discriminated against. They do not receive legal recognition unless they can prove that they have had gender reassignment surgery. They are legally allowed to change their gender since 2018. There are 480,000 transgender people in India. LGBTQ+ rights in India have been evolving very fast lately. However, members from the LGBTQ+ community in India still face problems with discrimination, both in society and legally. And they are still not legally protected. In 2018, the Indian Supreme Court legalized consensual homosexual sex between two adults. Despite political movement and demonstrations in favor of the LGBTQ+ community, there's still a lot of homophobia in India. According to an opinion poll, 1 in 4 people are against same-sex relationships. Members of the LGBTQ+ community are gaining more and more respect and tolerance from the society, especially in large cities. In 2021, a report about LGBTQ+ pride was released. It showed that 2% of the Indians identify neither as male nor female. which means they are non-binary or gender fluid. The report also showed that 3% identify as homosexual, 9% is bisexual, 1% is pansexual, and 3% is asexual. Only 17% identify as homosexual. The rest said, I don't know or I don't want to answer. Have a nice day and thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.